In this next section, we will cover chromosome structure and packaging. DNA is organized into long linear structures called chromosomes. Chromosomes consist of both DNA and the proteins used to organize and fold it. The diagram here shows a replicated, condensed chromosome that is getting ready to divide and be separated into daughter cells. Each one of the two identical replicated chromosomes is called a chromatid. Chromatids are held together at the centromere of the chromosomes. From the centromere, the long arm of the chromosome is the Q arm, and the short arm is the P arm. Recall that prokaryotic cells like bacteria do not contain any organelles. Thus, the chromosomal DNA exists as a circular structure in a region of the cell known as the nucleoid region. Prokaryotic DNA often exists in a supercoiled state rather than the relaxed circular state. DNA supercoiling refers to the over or underwinding of a DNA strand and is the expression of strain on the strand. Supercoiling is important in a number of biological processes, such as compacting the DNA, and by regulating access to the genetic code. Supercoils can exist as twists with different amounts of writhing that occur in the right-handed or left-handed orientation. Writhing is said to occur when distinct lobe structures form in the DNA. Supercoils can also be tightly wound into plectonemic or toroidal conformations. Supercoiling is mediated by enzymes known as topoisomerases. Later this term, when we're focused on the processes of DNA replication and transcription, we will discuss topoisomerase enzymes in more detail. Atomic force microscopy can be used to visualize some of these different states, including the relaxed, plectonemic, and a combination of plectonemic and toroidal states. Sometimes during the process of replication, the two sister chromatids can get entangled with one another, forming knots or becoming catenated. The topoisomerase enzymes, also called gyrases, are critical for unknotting and decatenating the DNA. Circular chromosomes are also found within the mitochondrial organelles of eukaryotic cells, supporting the hypothesis that they originated as prokaryotic organisms that became symbionts with an early eukaryotic progenitor cell. The mitochondrial genome contains 13 protein encoding regions and 22 tRNA encoding genes. These are involved in the biosynthesis of critical metabolic enzymes housed within the mitochondria. Eukaryotic chromosomes, on the other hand, are housed within the nucleus of the cell and differ from prokaryotic DNA in that the chromosomes exist as long, linear structures rather than being circular in nature. The major proteins associated with the chromosome are known as histones. Histones are highly alkaline proteins. Note that DNA has a lot of negative charge load due to the phosphate groups. Thus, the alkaline nature or positive nature of the histones keeps them attracted to the DNA. Histones 3 and 4 form a dimer, and histones 2A and 2B also form a dimer. Both of these dimers will form a tetramer complex and then combine to form a histone octamer. This octamer structure provides a protein core that the DNA can wrap around. This DNA histone core is called a nucleosome. Here's a side view diagram and a top-down diagram of the nucleosome core. Note that histones 2A, 2B, H3, and H4 form the octamer core, while histone H1, shown in green, serves to seal the nucleosome structure and is also a coordination point for higher order structuring of the DNA. So it serves as a linker. Note that the DNA is wrapped two times around the core of the histones, forming the nucleosome complex. Once the DNA is wrapped onto the histone core to form the nucleosomes, The nucleosomes can assemble into higher order structures, such as solenoids or zigzags. The solenoids and zigzags can then be stacked into a very organized structure. When the cell is not replicating the DNA or getting ready to divide, it is in a phase called interphase, and the DNA is relaxed and diffuse. In this state, regions of the DNA can be unwound from the histones to allow transcription, and hence gene expression to take place. During DNA replication and cell division, the DNA condenses into a very tightly wound structure, forming the characteristic sister chromatid X structure. The DNA is typically not being transcribed in this state. Chromosomes in interphase are much more dynamic than when they are condensed and highly structured for cell division. A number of different models have been proposed to describe the structure of interphase DNA, especially differences in chromosomal DNA that is being actively transcribed versus inactive DNA. You will not be required to know these different models, but can read more about them if you're interested. The ends of the chromosome pose a special problem for linear chromosomal DNA. They provide a region that is much more susceptible to degradation, and they cannot be fully replicated during DNA replication. To aid in maintaining the stability of the chromosome and creating a mechanism for replicating the ends, special structures called telomeres exist at the ends of each linear chromosome. Telomeres are long regions of DNA, they're thousands of bases long, that repeat this simple sequence TTAGGG over and over again. So it's a highly repetitive sequence. The telomerase enzyme, shown here in yellow, binds with a small RNA template molecule that is complementary with the TTAGGG sequence. Thus, it can base pair with this region and serve as a template, enabling the elongation of the chromosomal ends. However, the telomerase enzyme required for this elongation process is only present within embryos and is turned off shortly after birth. Thus, over a lifetime, each round of DNA replication will result in a shortening of the chromosome. At some point, the telomeres become critically short. This attrition leads to cell senescence, where the cell is unable to divide or apoptotic cell death occurs. Telomeres are the basis for what's called the Hayflick limit, or the number of times that a cell is able to divide before reaching senescence. While telomerase reactivation may seem to be the solution to longevity, it is also problematic as overexpression of telomerase occurs often in tumor cells that have become cancerous. It's not clear if there can be safe expression levels of telomerase to maintain chromosomal length without causing harmful diseases. In addition to being places where the ends of the chromosome can be elongated, telomeres also stabilize the DNA by forming highly complex three-dimensional shapes at the ends of the chromosomes. Within this structure, four guanine bases form a flat plate, which is then stacked on top of one another, forming a stable G-quadruplex structure. So this figure here is like we're looking down on top of the center of the double helix, and it shows this quadruplex structure. Other structures, such as T-loops and D-loops, can also sometimes form within this region. And this leads us to the last section of Chapter 4, where we will cover some of the major findings revealed during the sequencing of the human genome.